Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to combine multiple hooks together like use state, use effect, use reducer, and we'll see how we can achieve that. Okay, so I think that is going to be very simple. We can simply write a simple form, okay, and which that form can have two fields, username and password. Okay, so here you can see I have a form, set form. I mean, if you are starting this particular video, then it's not a good option. You have to start from the playlist because all these videos are kind of a linked. In the previous set of videos, I have covered a few hooks, and now this is another video where I'm trying to combine these all these hooks together. So in this use state, I have an object which is having two things, username and email. So this is initially empty, and you can say password instead of email. Okay, these are the two properties I have in the use state hook. So this is how we can use use state hook. And there can be another thing is use effect hook. How to write it? You already have seen the syntax and how to properly write it. I will just provide dependency array initially empty, and you don't have anything to clean up for now, so we'll just return that. Okay, now from this HTML code, we are actually going to write a form. Okay, so form will have two text fields, input type text. We have written this form many times. So, and value for this form is form.username. It is coming from the state, and on change, you will be triggering something. Like consider that I have update field method. So similarly, I have another field which I'm using for password. Input type, you can say I have a password form dot password. Okay, and then there is a submit button, because here on submit I'm doing something on submit. Handle submit, this is a function, and there is in button type submit. So here we are trying to submit the form. Okay, so here we have a username and the password. Input type password, name you can say input type text, name equal to username. Here name you can pass, just identifier for us. Now we have one method which is update value, update field, which is going to update the username whenever you type it. So we'll write it this function. What this function is doing is it will capture the value whatever you are entering in the text field. Okay, so here you are actually getting the event object. Event object means e.target.value. From there we can get the state, and now here we will do set state, set form, sorry, and in the set form whatever we have as existing form will not update it. Okay, I mean the existing state and the new state. Now instead of creating two different methods for like handle username change, handle password change, we can combine both of them in a single function. So what we can do is e.target.name, and we are setting it with the e.target.value. So this name property is important. It is setting the username because this name property is being consumed here, name and value. Okay, update field is actually updating this state directly. Okay, we can pass something like, okay, if form is getting updated, then we can always check the validity of this particular form. So here we can have another state which is valid, set valid. Okay, use state, it is initially the form is invalid, means the validation is not set. Here we can check form.username. First of all, form should be there. Form.username is there. It should be the length of this, because it will not be null. Always username will be empty, so we can just check the length. Length should be greater than 2. And then form dot password dot length should be greater than whatever the character you wanted to set. And then if that is condition is meeting, set valid equal to true. So we are able to use the use effect hook also. Whenever this form object is getting changed, this use effect will trigger and it will set the validity of our form. And we can write this handle submit method. So this handle submit will take care of submitting the form. So here we can just check if form is valid, then just do the form submission. Here we are just printing the values. Otherwise, do not submit, return from here, because set valid is false. So you can just show the alert message or something, right? Now this video is just talking about how we are combining these use state, use effect, maybe use reducer also. Here we don't have a use case of that. So update field, here we are writing one common method, update field, which is actually updating the username and the password. Okay, both these properties we are updating, and we are setting the particular key value pairs. So form has a username and password. We are able to update it in a single function, something like this. Existing form object, and this is your properties you are updating. Username with the value, password with the value. So it will update the form value. Whenever the form is getting updated, we have to check the validity of the form by just checking the length of username and the password. Why it is complaining? Oh, sorry. Should be if, yeah, so it's a condition check, and then we are setting set valid is a true. We don't have anything to clean up here, and then handle submit will just check the validity status of a form. If it is valid, it will submit the form, right? Very simple. But here we are combining both these logics together and we are writing this form, right? So if you just try to save it and see this in the action. So here we are submitting this form. So on submit, you have to prevent this e dot prevent default or e dot stop propagation and all these things. Propagation. Now, if this is valid, we can actually make an API call here and send. If this is not valid, like if the form is not valid, then we can just see that form is not being submitted. We are just directly returned. We are not making API call, right? So this is how you can actually combine the things, combine the hooks together.